I think the way it came into reality really was that NParks, the National Parks Board of Singapore, held an international competition. And we were one of the shortlisted teams for the competition. They awarded Marina East to ourselves, Gustafson Porter, and Marina South to Andrew Grant and Wilkinson Air. And since that time, we've both been working. It was interesting because at the beginning, we actually worked together. We attended a lot of the meetings, same meetings together. And then they sort of split off into two different projects. And we've been working on the project since, I'd say, 2007. And we've looked at the overall master plan, refined the master plan, and completed the concept design for Marina East.
The theme of transformation of WAF is very applicable here because this is a piece of regained land. It was basically sea before, and it has been filled in and provided a new environment for the Singapore people. So it's come from basically being sort of muddy, swampy delta type of piece at the end of a river to actually a very healthy piece of land that can have housing, can have infrastructure on it, parks on it. And within that, we are also transforming that land to meet sustainable goals, where we're making sure that all the gardens are on the roofs, that all the buildings are integrated into the landscape, and so that as we work with global warming and sustainability, that this is as close as we can get to be a zero carbon park, which would be really nice for the future of Singapore and for the planet.
Oh yes, I think one of the big challenges is the fact that the site that we're working on was previously sea. So the first challenge is to stabilize the ground and ensure that it's, you know, because it'll go through a natural process of settlement over a number of years. So that's a big challenge. And we work together with engineers, with Arup Associates in London, and they developed a whole system of compacting the ground using wick drains and so on. The other big challenge was obviously water and how to control and contain and recycle as much water as possible. The other challenge, I suppose, it's not really a challenge, but it is working together with a lot of different agencies in Singapore as we develop the project. You know, the URA and the PUB, Water Board, and the people in charge of overall development, the LTA, the transport people. So that's really part of an integrated piece of urban redevelopment for Singapore.
One of the amazing things about the Singapore government is that they keep looking for ways to introduce nature into their city or make nature more apparent in their city. And that nature could be man nature, like botanical gardens, but it also can be very much showing what the natural nature is. And they have this canopy walk that you walk on these elevated pathways, like 30 meters in the air between this wonderful forest. And there's panels that tell you what tree is in front of you, what it does in your environment, what products come from it, you know, all the history of the tree. And then you move to other areas and you cross this beautiful valley with a bridge called Henderson Waves that is phenomenally engineered. It's one of the most beautiful bridges in the world. And they create these extraordinary pieces as tourist destinations, but for their own people also. So it's a pretty wonderful government to work for because of their sensitivity to the environment and their knowledge of what they have as an extraordinary environment.
Well, it's our first day, so we've been wandering around a bit. It's great. I think it's great to see all the different projects, and obviously bumped into a lot of people that one knows. So I think it's a great venue, and we've been really really pleased to have the opportunity to talk and to showcase the Singapore project. It's been great.
Of course, they have a responsibility, but it's constantly changing, that responsibility, because your responsibility is built on knowledge, and as your knowledge changes, your responsibility to work with that knowledge changes. I feel like we have a responsibility as professionals to try to seek or endeavor to do absolutely the best we can with the information we have and seek new information and then communicate it to our clients, or if our clients has more information than we have, to take that on board and carry it further What do you think?
I think it's a huge responsibility, really. When you think of the amount of investment that clients put in architects and landscape architects, you know, they're huge amounts of money that are being put forward. And of course you have a responsibility to use the resource wisely and to bring a kind of intellectual capital to the project, and then to execute it in a professional way and ensure that it stands up and does all the things that it's going to do. And you carry the responsibility for years afterward, for 6 or 12 years afterward. It's a big responsibility.
Social engineering is an interesting term that I'd never heard before, but our job is public. We are here to create public space. And whether the architects are creating public space, the landscape architects are creating public space, it is our job. The thing about the public is that the public's constantly changing. And you know you're changing about what you want to do, what you've learned, what you think would be interesting, what activities you want to do. So part of our job is sort of like, I call it having the antennas out and understanding what are the spaces that work today. How are they going to transform? There will be always the classic space, you know, the plaza, that type of thing. But there are new spaces, and these new spaces are about how we're looking at the ecology and looking at the sustainability. So it's about transformation, it's about work, it's about food, it's about how close things are together, where our materials come from. And so those are creating totally new kind of spaces that we're living in, and making sure that those spaces that we create today are really about the future, not about a way of living that actually hasn't worked very well for us as far as energy, climate, spending. I think there is a way to be extremely pragmatic, but at the same time very creative. And I think that's part of what our job is to constantly evolve within those criteria. That's the best I can answer.